York, the dramatic parade of major world figures across the stage of history continues. Cuba's Fidel Castro boards a Soviet airliner to return to Havana. A little hoarse from his non-stop four-hour marathon speech before the General Assembly. Local police, eased by the departure of New York's most troublesome transient in quite a while, have two new VIPs to guard. President Sukarno of Indonesia arrives to address the General Assembly and to meet with other foreign leaders. Sukarno stands as a neutralist between the Soviet and the free world bloc. Shortly afterwards, King Hussein of Jordan arrives, already on record in complete disagreement with Khrushchev's plan to reorganize the UN. While here, Hussein will meet with other notables, but not Nasser of Egypt, with whom relations verge on outright hostility. At the United Nations next day, one of the most distinguished diplomatic audiences in all history, hears Britain's Prime Minister Harold MacMillan defend Secretary General Hammarskjöld's Congo policies, only to be met with an astonishing outburst by Khrushchev. Three times the Soviet leader went into tantrums during MacMillan's speech, unprecedented breaches of etiquette that literally shocked most of the delegates present. MacMillan went on to urge progress towards disarmament, his sober presentation in telling contrast to the boorish outbursts of Khrushchev left the General Assembly aghast.